Good morning. Today we talk about time management. Time management is an SAP HR module related to the employee working time. It's divided into two areas: time recording and time evaluation. Time recording is to record absence, attendance, clock in and clock out for your employee. Time evaluation is to evaluate this kind of working time for a payroll purpose. So if you want to insert a new absence in our system, you have to use PA61 transaction code. Then select absence and indicate a period for your absence, start date and end date, and then choose a subtype, so an absence type, for example, vacation. Then we click on create. And we have to save this record. For the day after, for example, we want to insert a clock in and clock out. So we have to select, in this case, time events and choose list entry. Then the start date, also in this case, the end date. The time entry, for example, 9 a.m. and the clock out, so when employee finish his work. Okay, then save also in this case. And then we can, for example, select attendance. Attendance is for employee working time. So from attendance, we have to choose for example, transfers in this case, also the start date and the end date, create, and also in this case, save. In SAP HR Time Management, there is another important concept related to the absence. Certain absence could be related to a time quota. Time quota is a balance of absence for which we can use certain days or hours for a period. For example, if I want to check for our system which are the absence quota already active for a current year, I select absence quota and the current year, and then I click on overview. In this case, I could check that there is a vacation quota per me, training and rest, and the start date and date is for the current year. For vacation, in this example, we have already used one day. If I want to check when I used vacation, I select the time quota, then I click on change, on go to, and deduction. On deduction, I can view that there is an absence already used for vacation in this year. Okay, so come back and talk about time evaluation because now we have record absence and attendance, so we have to run the time evaluation to evaluate our employee working time. So come back on SAP menu and click on Time Evaluation Transaction Code PT60. Then insert the employee number, the evaluation schema and time statement variant already created in our system, and the period of our evaluation. Then run transaction and system show us a time statement. Time statement is a summary of our employee working time evaluation. The first section is a summary of our master data, for example, last name, the first name. We can find also the period of evaluation, period, the work schedule, and also the personal area in which our employee work. Then there is a section named individual result, which each day evaluate, and the reason for each date that we found, for example, vacation or the clock in, clock out, when our employee started work and ended work, and also the attendance type that we insert for this day. There is another section named monthly result, and also a time wage type section in which we have every wage type that we send to payroll for a payroll statement, so for the salary. And the last section is called absence quota. Absence quota is the section in which we have every absence that has a quota type related, for example, vacation with the due balance, the used hours or day, and the remain for the period for which absence quota is generated. There is another important concept in time management, is the time management pool, PT40 transaction. With this transaction, I can see, for example, error that system raise for our employee. In this case, so to see if there is some error in time evaluation, I have to click on error handling and click on continue. In this case, system doesn't raise for us any error. So this employee has no error in the time evaluation. But if I want to create an error only to see what happened, I click on maintain transaction. So in this case, we want to create an error for a time event. Imagine that our employee forgot the clock out, so he insert record only the time event in the morning when he started work, but he forget to clock out when he finish his working day. So we save the clock in and then we run again the time evaluation for our employee. At the end of the run of this evaluation, you can see that there is no is locked on this day because the clock out is absence, and so for the system is a very important kind of error, the missing of a clock out. How can I manage this error? Only to click on time management pool. I set for my employee number, I click on error handling, and as you can see, there is this kind of error. I select the message with the error, click on time event, and in this case, I can insert a clock out for the missing day. For example, the clock out at 6. Save. Then I go back, I run again the time evaluation, and in this case I can see the day. So it means that for the system there is no more error. If I want to see if there is some error, I click again on PT40 transaction. I insert the employee number, and if I want to see again if there is some error, I click on error handling. And as you can see, employee has no more error found in the system. So it doesn't mean that system doesn't find anything, and so this is the way how to manage error after a time evaluation. I hope you can find interesting my video and that you can follow me for other video tutorial. Thank you.